Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see how to find leaders in an array. So what does a leader in an array means? Let us say you have an array having 6 elements. Okay, so how do you find the leaders in this array? You will start from the first element. Okay, and then you will see whether this first element is greater than all the elements to the right hand side. If this is true, then the current element will be the leader of this array. Okay, so you can see that this 15 is not the greatest among all the elements which are present to its right, because 18 is greater than 15. Therefore 15 is not the leader. Now we will move to the next element and we will see for 18. Okay, so is 18 greater than all the elements to the right hand side? You can see that yes, it's true. 18 is greater than all the elements to the right hand side. Therefore 18 will be a leader. Okay, now we move on to the next element, 5. Is 5 greater than all the elements to the right hand side? You can see that no, it's not true, because 6 is lying on the right hand side and 6 is greater than 5. Therefore 5 will not be a leader. Is 3 a leader? No, because 6 is lying to the right hand side. Is 6 a leader? Yes, because there is only one element, 2, to the right of 6, and 2 is lower than 6. Therefore 6 will be a leader. And the rightmost element is always a leader, because there is no element to the right hand side. So this will be the largest. Therefore the rightmost element of an array is always a leader. Therefore from this entire array you have 3 leaders, 18, 6 and 2. And this method which I showed you is the brute force method. Okay, because what we are doing is we are basically fixing one element and then we are traversing all the right elements. Okay, and then comparing whether there is an element which is greater than the current element. Okay, so this will take a total of order of n square, because for each fixation we will have to traverse the entire array. So that will take order of n square time. So how do you reduce the time? How do you find an efficient approach? Let us assume the same array, 15, 18, 5, 3, 6 and 2. What can be an efficient approach in order to find all the leaders in an array? You will have to take a variable known as max element. Okay, and that will keep track of the maximum elements seen so far. And instead of traversing from left to right, we will traverse from right to left. Okay, so we will come to the first element, that means the rightmost element. And then max element will be equals to the rightmost element, which is 2, and then we will have the output, because as soon as we see a leader, then we will print it in the output. Okay, so you already know that the rightmost element will be a leader, therefore we will always put it in output and we will assign this max element with the rightmost element, which is 2. Okay, now we move to its left. We will compare the current element, which is 6, with the max element seen so far. If the current element is greater than the max element seen so far, then obviously there will be no element to the right of current element which will be greater than the current element, because we are already traversing from right to left. You can see that 6 is greater than the max element seen so far. Therefore there will be no element which is greater than 6 and lying to its right. Therefore we will just output this 6 and we will update this max element with 6, because the max element seen so far is 6. Now we will move to its left. Now we will compare 3 with 6. You can see that 3 is lower than 6, so this can never be a leader. Now we move left. We compare 5 with 6. 5 is lower than 6. We again move to its left. We can see that 18 is greater than 6. Therefore 18 will be a leader. And we move left, but before moving left we will update this max element. This will be 18. We will move to 15. 15 is lower than 18, so this cannot be a leader, and all the elements have now been traversed. Therefore you can see that the leaders are 2, 6 and 18, and this approach only takes a time of order of n, because we are traversing this entire array only once, from right to left. I hope this video was helpful. If you find any difficulty, then please comment below. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you in our next video. Thank you.